experienced and the experiencer to merge in experiencing. Allow the knower and the known to merge in knowing. The subjective name for this knowing is I. The objective name of this knowing is the world. Two faces of the same infinite, indivisible reality. Venture anywhere you please in the realm of experience. A deep depression, the experience of being in love, a near-death experience, the taste of tea, or just our current experience. All that is ever encountered is the knowing of experience. In fact, not even the knowing of experience, as if experience were one thing and the knowing of it another. Knowing, or pure experiencing, is the only substance, if we can call it a substance, that is ever known. And what is it that knows this knowing? Only knowing can know this knowing. All there is knowing, knowing only, knowing. Knowing, knowing, knowing. I. each of us as apparently individual people are. Not entities, but the activities through which this knowing knows itself as experience, as thinking, feeling, sensing, perceiving. In other words, each of us is not an entity or a person in its own right, but rather the activity through which and as which God knows itself as the world. Don't allow the multiplicity and diversity of experiences to persuade you that there is anything other than a single, intimate, indivisible, and infinite reality. A reality that shines as the amness of ourselves on the inside, and that shines as the isness of the world on the outside. Allow the sensation of the body to come to your attention. Drop the label body, our only experience of the body if our eyes are closed, and I suggest we keep our eyes closed, is the current sensation or flow of sensations. This flow of sensations comprise both neutral or functional sensations, such as the tingling at the soles of our feet or our hands or face, but it also includes feelings, be sure that both are equally included in this contemplation. Now, visualize and feel that you travel to the very interior of this feeling sensation. You travel into its interior through layers of feeling all the way to the heart or the core of this feeling sensation. In particular, with feelings, go to the very core of any feelings that may be present. Not just your superficial responses to your current experience, but the deeper layers of feeling. If it is helpful to go back in time to visit the very earliest feelings that were laid down in infancy, then permit yourself to do so. You are not really going back in time, you are going into the depths of yourself. Visualize and feel the very core of this elemental feeling sensation in your heart. And visualize that this space is dark. It rarely, if ever, sees the light of awareness. Visualize that you light a candle flame at the center of this dark cavity. And immediately the darkness is illuminated by the warmth and the radiance of this flame. Visualize and feel that this innermost chamber where our deepest, darkest feelings reside is illuminated by this flame. It is bathed in the warmth and the radiance that is emitted from this flame. visualize and feel that this flame begins to grow. And as it grows, it intensifies. And as the light of this flame intensifies, it penetrates into the, its light penetrates into the dark cavern more deeply. The flame is now a couple of inches in diameter in the center of your heart. Shedding its warmth on everything it encounters. And also consuming everything it encounters. Turning everything it encounters into itself. Flame continues to expand in all directions. It is 4 inches in diameter. Filling up this cavity of the heart with its warmth and radiance, and gently consuming everything it encounters. Not only any feelings that may be present, but sensations or any tensions or knots of resistance. Offer everything to this flame. The flame is 6 inches in diameter. It is beginning to fill up your chest, turning everything it encounters into itself. this flame now fills your entire rib cage. Offer or surrender every feeling or sensation that this expanding flame encounters. The flame begins to grow upwards into the throat area and at the same time sink downwards into the belly. First of all, illuminating any feelings, tensions or resistances that it encounters. Then bathing those feelings, tensions or resistances with its warmth and radiance. And in time consuming them, turning them into itself. Be sensitive to any pockets of resistance, particularly any feelings that seem to be too dense or dark to be consumed by this fire. Take time there, surrender them to this fire. visualize and feel that the flame grows upwards into the cavities of the mouth and ears and nose. And fills out the space of the belly. Flame begins to descend into the pelvic area and starts to lick the eye cavities and your brain. Fills the legs and the shoulders and the arms. Visualize and feel that the whole body is on fire now, not a painful fire, a warm, radiant fire. This warm radiance is turning the entire substance of the body into itself. This fire is called the fire of pure knowing. It first illuminates everything. It then bathes everything in its warmth and radiance. And then it consumes everything, turns everything it encounters into itself. It is also known as the fire of love. Soon the entire body has been consumed and there is nothing else for this fire to feed on. And very slowly the flames begin to peter out. In other words, it first of all consumes everything it comes in contact with. It consumes the body. And then when there is nothing else to feed on, it dissolves into itself. Soon the fire, the flames die down completely. There is nothing left to consume. It brings itself to its own ending. And all that remains is the uncreated light of pure knowing. Or the radiance of love. was the slow movement from one of the late Beethoven string quartets. It was one of the last pieces of music he wrote. He was deaf when he wrote it, and he wrote it as a thanksgiving to God for his life. Let's be silent till we're in the dining room. Thank you.